Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at the difference between minimizing and hiding an app and when you should use each. So here I am working in Pages. This could be any app. I've got the app running. You can tell right here it says Pages. And I've got a window open here with a document in it. Now, a common thing for people to want to do is to stop working on it for a little while, but maybe not close the document, maybe not quit out of Pages. It's easy enough to quit, of course, and get out of Pages, but you want to keep working on it, just bring some other things to the front, check your email, look at the web, a few things like that. So a common mistake people make is to use one of these buttons up here, particularly this minimize button. This is a common mistake Windows users use. They say, I want to get Pages out of the way, I'll click that. Now Pages is gone. Now I can go and run other apps and Pages isn't in the way. But notice after I've done that, Pages is still the app that's running. The document window goes here into the dock and I can bring it back up. But what I've actually done here is I haven't hidden or minimized Pages in any way. I've just minimized this one window. For instance, say if I open up a new document here, I'm just going to just open up a sample document. I've got now two document windows open in Pages and I can switch between them, view them both at the same time. If I click the minimize button, it notice it doesn't minimize Pages. I still got this one open. It deals with each document window separately and I can minimize both of them. I can have eight windows open and minimize some of them and have others here. But Pages is always running. So if you want to get rid of Pages, just completely hide everything, you may be tempted to minimize this window and minimize this window and move on. But that's not the way to do it on the Mac. The way to do it on the Mac is simply hide the app. It's very quick and easy. You can go to Pages and hit Hide Pages or Command H, which is pretty universal as the hide command. Command H and Pages goes away completely. The app isn't running anymore. It's just all completely hidden. I can bring it back very easily by clicking on Pages here in the dock to bring it back. I can hide it again. Also, if I'm using the application switcher, I can use Command Tab to switch and go back to Pages and everything opens. Notice what happens if I minimize, say, both of these windows and then I use the Command Switcher to switch, say, to Calendar and then I want to go use Command Tab to switch back to Pages. It doesn't look like anything comes up. It's because these windows are both minimized, which most likely isn't your intention. The only reason to really use minimize is if you're working on several documents and you only want to hide one of them and leave another one at the front. If you want everything to be hidden from an app, use Command H to quickly hide it. Now it works this way regardless of whether or not the application even has more than one window. For instance, Calendar just has one window here. I can minimize it if I want, but if I use app switching to go to Safari and then back to Calendar, the window is not going to reappear until I click down here. So I'm creating extra work for myself. In Safari here, I can minimize a single window or I can do Command H, hide the entire thing. So for Power Mac users, for experienced Mac users like myself, I use Command H all the time, hundreds of times a day to move between applications very easily. I almost never use minimize, but a lot of Windows users kind of gravitate to this because it looks like something similar to what you do in Windows, but really is a little different here and it's just something you should rarely use on a Mac. Now you should also note that there's another option here. Say I'm in Pages here, I've got both these windows open, and I'm going to maybe take a break for a while and stop working with these documents. What if I just quit? Just Command Q, quit. You think, well, you know, it's going to be, I'm going to have to open up Pages, I'm going to have to find those documents again. Well, that's not the case really, because the way macOS 10 works is when you relaunch Pages, it of course brings up those documents right away. Documents are automatically saved, so you don't have to do any of your own manual saving before you quit, and it comes right back to where you were and where you were working on them before. So you don't necessarily have to hide an app. You can actually quit it if you're not going to go right back to it in a few minutes and then come back and just run it later. And this works for all the Mac apps like Pages, Numbers, Keynote, and a lot of other newer apps as well. For some apps like older stuff or stuff that's not necessarily Mac only like some of the Adobe products, then you have to do the old-fashioned save and then open it up again. But This works great if you're working, say, with some Pages documents or Numbers documents or even in something like iMovie or GarageBand. It's very easy just to come back in after you quit.